So here I am at the Wilshire Grand Center on 7th at Figueroa. There's a mobility hub here. It had a bicycle symbol on it, but it's locked. There's nothing there. So we'll have to see what the mobility hub is all about. So we're going to head back to, this will be the new headquarters, Los Angeles headquarters for the AROOP group. And we're going to head back to the west side, Playa Vista, from here, see how a commute might be going back. Thank you. So we're going to head down. Here you can see how big it is. You can look up. You can, on the 360 video, you can look up, you know. So we're going to head down on 7th to Flower and take Flower out of downtown. We took Figueroa coming up to see what the new cycle track was like. But we're going to see what Flower is like heading back out of downtown. Yeah, cyclist passing me on the right. We have a bit of a squeeze. Here's Flower. I guess I can, he's probably going straight. I'm going to squeeze up. I know what this guy's doing. Pedestrians through. Okay, so this is one way. Now, that's kind of neat. Go by Macy's here. My mother would like that. Worked many years for Macy's in Queens, New York City. So I got 2¼ miles on Flower. Oh, I guess I went there. We'll see how the mic handles it. I got a little sock cover over the microphone hole. And hopefully that will give some protection to the wind. So this contrast, in many ways, with Figueroa, it's one way. There's no bicycle facilities of any type. You got like four lanes going south. And this will be our way out of downtown, heading back toward the west side. We have a stop truck here. A little bit of a downhill, which is nice. Pretty cool still this morning. Pretty place for a truck to stop. Here we have a car coming out. So I have pretty wide bike lane here. The right lane. Legally I could use the left lane too, if I'm slower than other traffic. I think I'm going to make this one. Nope. Didn't stop the red car. The old acceleration. Real estate investor seeks student. Huh. That's cool. Here we are at Olympic. Flower in Olympic. There's a Ritz-Carlton over there. I like some of the old style buildings. Look at the cornice work there. Don't see that then anymore. Another 8 seconds. So it is now 9:37 on Tuesday, September 18th, 9:37 a.m. So I rode downtown from the west side, from Playa Vista, starting around 7 with the morning rush hour. So this should be quite a terrible amount of traffic. This shouldn't be much at all as we get into the later morning. Need to get left here to get out of the right turn lane. Lemon Street on Flower, heading south. There was a shadow there in the middle of the lane. Kind of worn off. Here's another one. Freshen those up and put bikes by useful lane sign. What line is it? This is the Long Beach Blue Line. Moving at 17 miles an hour. Pico. Oh, that turns into a parking lane. Fashion District. Figueroa corridor ahead. So, now we see why it's sort of one way here. I guess it was two-way and they put the train in? Not sure. So, this is easy cruising. Nice. This is nice. This is nice. Seventeen miles an hour. Here's Venice. I could refresh the lane markings here a little bit. Here we are, Washington Boulevard, Volkswagen dealership, downtown LA, Los Angeles Trade Technical College. Welcome to Trade Tech, LA, never heard of it. Oh, you glance behind me when it turns green to see if I have a bunch of traffic behind that I could release, but nothing there. So this is sort of in keeping with my impression of Los Angeles traffic on the surface streets. That means not on the freeways. It's either little traffic like this, or it's so congested that the bicycles don't slow anybody down. Actually, the bikes can go faster than the motor traffic when it's heavily congested. So this is obviously the uncongested condition that we're seeing here. Photo enforced traffic light. There it is, there's the camera. Twenty-third Street. So I should do this in the evening coming back. So next time I go downtown, I'll go down like mid-afternoon and come back with the heavier traffic. Now, do I get in that right lane? Or is it going to become parking again? Yeah, it's parking. Where is all the traffic, LA? Oh no. Pedal pushers, as in flower petals, on the right side. There's the new Astor Hotel open. So I got nothing happening here. This is so boring and so easy. I should talk some more about CyclingSavvy. CyclingSavvy. I can talk about the four dimensions. The first dimension is our priorities. Cyclist safety. Safety is number one. Cycling is safe, and we can make it even safer by being relevant, visible, communicative, cooperative, using lane control so that motorists don't make mistakes. Like right hooks and left crosses and drive outs and doorings and buzz passes. So that's the first priority. Second priority is cooperation. We need to be cooperative. Obviously at an always stop sign, take your turn and first come, first serve. Just getting along. Another priority is convenience. Cycling has to be convenient. So we need access to the full road system. You know, like laws that require us to use shoulders or bike paths or bike lanes or stay far to the right. We want things to be convenient so we can choose the route that works best for each individual. And then fourth priority is legality. We want to follow the laws. Although sometimes the law might not work quite as well for cyclists as for motorists, as I mentioned, these mandatory use laws. But for the most part, we operate according to the rules of the road and the traffic laws. Stopping at red lights, yielding at stop signs, using the proper lane. I'm not going to get in this right lane if I'm going straight. So why did it send me on to Figueroa already? That was too early. 1¾ miles. I thought I was going to go much further down on Flower. But now it's taking me across sooner. I might go back on Flower, because I want to see what that's like. Heading straight down. So I might get over to the left here and make a U-turn. No U-turn. Yeah, and then look at this. So I might have to do some pedestrian hopping around here. I'll check the map on the corner. Let's see what it's doing. I could pull it out here, but this is USC, huh? Right, left onto Rodeo. Oh no, we're already here. Okay, I'm gonna keep going. Rodeo is what I want. So I am where I want to be, apparently. Here we go. Traffic behind to release. Yeah, I could release some. And then get out of this lane. Actually, this sort of lines up. Well, I can roll right through this. And then start to control the lane again. Like here. A little bit of a tailwind here. Moving at 17. Pretty nice. Yeah, where's Rodeo? I like Rodeo. Hey, cyclist. This is USC campus here. Knee deep in Los Angeles on the LA show of 2018. Hot since 82. This is the expo line here. Speed limit 35. There's our sidewalk cyclist. So where is Rodeo? Do we see what way? Famille de Saint-Claude. University of Southern California, there you go. So Robinson Lane. Where is Rodeo? This is Vermont. I'm tempted to look at my map. University Expo Park West. Is that the right turn only lane, I hope? Well, we have a bike lane here. Edge bike lane, we'll see how that works out. I'm gonna check my map. Are we really heading toward Rodeo here? Looks like it, yeah. Right left on Rodeo. Where am I now? They're right there. Exposition. I'm on exposition. Okay. And then I'm going to make this slight left into Rodeo in a little bit. Yeah, obviously this is exposition because I got the light rail here, expo line. So we got the edge bike lane. Oh, it's the door zone bike lane too. That's so nice. The garbage bin bike lane too. That gives me a good excuse to leave the bike lane. That's this guy behind me. Thank you. Get a hose over. So that's a good use of bike lanes, is to put the garbage in there. That's cool. Now I'm going to have a slight left at a certain spot here. Now I got somebody behind me. The garbage. This is Normandy. See what we got up here. We're doing some bike lane with garbage bins. I'm going to control the lane. See what happens. By the parked cars. 19 miles an hour. Heck, on the bike lane with no parking. Tanker. I ran into that before. Again, bike lane is not mandatory here because according to California law, you don't need to use a bike lane any place as a drive, any place a right turn is authorized, which is essentially any driveways, approaching driveways or intersections. So unnecessary. I hope I didn't pass Rodeo. It's probably up here. Oh, Rodeo Road closed. That's nice. Like Crenshaw. But we'll see what happens here. And off of a bike, you can sneak through road closures because you can walk on the sidewalk or something like that. Anyway, I could get over to the left lane here, but I'll wait a little bit. Exposition in Western. Let's see what happens at Crenshaw. Am I still blinking up there? Oh, it's hard to see in that sunlight. I think so. Ah, the big question is, what will the sound be like? Now, I can do a little release here, because I do have quite a bit of traffic behind. So I'm going to let him go, and then I'll make my move over to the left lane. I could even wait for this light to turn red behind me. In 8 seconds, already stopped. Still have some through traffic here. Okay. So now they're stopped behind and I can easily move over into the left lane and come down Rodeo. Oh, I guess we have two lanes here. So I didn't have to be. I could have stayed here. Now we have a railroad crossing to deal with. No traffic behind at all, so I should be able to get the angle I want. I'm going to take up all lanes here and go way this way and cut across that way all the way because there's nobody near me. Oh, they have a bike crossing there to help the cyclists go in the other way. So I have 3.5 miles on Rodeo. The last time I was on Rodeo, this is not the one in Beverly Hills, by the way, although it might be, it might link up there, is there was little traffic, four lanes, and I thought no bike lane. I thought it was great. Now here, not what I remember, because here we have a parking lane. So this is probably a floating lane. Let's see what the parking. By that I mean it becomes a traffic lane during rush hour. Yeah. So during rush hour you get that lane back. So stopping 4 to 6 p.m. I think. So this is evening rush hour. So this is nice cycling in L.A. Arlington and Rodeo Road. I guess the other is Rodeo Drive, right? Fancy one. Speed limit 40. But look at this. Black Cannabis Company. Established 2007. Wow. 11 years before legalization in California. So just cruising, moving at 16, heart rate 125, easy, easy. I do have, this is a bit of a downslope as you leave the city center and move toward the coast. Obviously, you're going to be losing altitude, because the coast is at sea level by definition. Picking up the garbage. Ah, this is nice. This is nice. I'm not even hitting traffic lights. Because I shouldn't have said that. So how could this be made better? Reduce the speed limit. Put centered shallows in the right lane. And put up bikes may use for lane signs. Reduce the speed limit to 25, 30, and enforce it, which isn't done in Los Angeles. So it looks like we're gonna lose a lane here. So I'll make sure that this could be used as a slow and release. I check back and make sure that a lot of traffic, I want them to get ahead of me before I have to take the single lane, but there's really nothing much back there. So I'll come out and do my thing. Just a construction, temporary lane closure. Wow, this is boring. Now, they don't want me going through here. So we may do a little bit of sidewalk. There's local access only. Well, we may not have to do that. So let's get to the local access to where the road is and see if we can get around on the sidewalk. It's a pain. From when to when? 9/7 to 10/15. Okay. Until mid-October. Let's see if I can get around. I mean, that's even nicer, because obviously there's not going to be any traffic. Or very little. Only local traffic. Oh, they have a little detour. Well, let's see if we do that. If it's just a matter of going around a little bit, we'll get to see some neighborhood streets. And there may be some neighborhood streets that we could use instead of even Rodeo Road. So, check this out. Private GPS just gave me the audible signal that I'm off the route. I wonder if there's going to be another sign up here directing me around and back onto Rodeo Road. You never know what goes through. Don't see a sign, but I'm assuming that I can get through here on Coliseum Street. Looks like it does go through. So here's a collector, two lane. Here's Crenshaw, where the work is being done. And I'll decide if I want to get back up there or stay on this, on Coliseum. Coliseum. Hey, want to come around? Come around. There you go. Happy way back. No way back. Not getting out. Have to check the video. I'm not seeing any waves. This is pretty good. There's no parking here. At least not now. Wonder why. So I'm on Coliseum. So this is it. I mean, once you wriggle around a little bit, you find a good route that you like. I see no real disadvantage of using Coliseum, but I am now. We still have a signal here on the busiest streets. Okay, here's the detour. Do I go back? Yeah, I'm going to go back because this isn't going to change much. I didn't have that sign up at the first right. So, not sure where I am now. Again, the ubiquitous residential street speed bumps, or speed humps, I guess. These are officially humps or bumps. Moving back up to Rodeo. Now, what is Rodeo? I'm gonna get back on Jefferson, which is gonna be a challenge, I think, but we'll see. In that, it's Doors on bike lane. This is Rodeo. It looks like traffic was deviated around the other side too. I was on Buckingham here. Are we still blinking red? Yep. And that'd be the most level. A lot of deviated traffic here. making a left. We're gonna have to wait for the light to change. I get back on Rodeo. Could have got in front of the truck there, but. Okay, here I go. He comes through the yellow, and now I got it. Okay, we're back on Rodeo Road after the detour around Crenshaw, which will last until October 15th. Good to know. Look at this. Is this not bicycling heaven? Look at this. Look at solar panels for the light. That's interesting. You think they would just wire them up to the electrical grid, but must have been cheaper to do this for some reason. The advantage is getting the red light, but they can be useful to get across streets. The short one on Hillcrest. No, that was friendly. Probably not. We call that the valley and territorial noise. When an animal, a mammal like a dog, sees you on his side or his sidewalk, it's all excited, barks. You think you shouldn't be there. So here I'll move over. No reason to really, so I'm gonna go back. Little traffic, and better to be out here and relevant. So we're still on Rodeo, that's Rodeo Lane, and Rodeo Road, double Rodeo. I slow down a little bit here, 15 miles an hour. What do we have here on the right? Electrical vehicle charging station. What is that? This is Rancho Cienega Sports Center. Tennis, swimming pool, skate. Sure, it's roller skate, I would guess. King Boulevard. Two traffic merge left, so we get a tight turn lane up here. Baldwin Village. Okay, so there's a neighborhood sign. I wish I saw more of those so I know where I was. Baldwin Village. King Boulevard and Rodeo Road. If it goes to my right, this is going to be turning right, I imagine. So I'm out of his way. Traffic going through gets on my left. U-Haul, that's a fancy U-Haul. Here I am at McDonald's at La Brea. La Brea and Rodeo Road. A bit more traffic now. Come on, come on, come on. Thank you. It's leaving. I'm gonna release here because I have this whole right lane. So there's your release on green. Get a long distance here to let the traffic by. Bus stop. Let it clear out. Light turns red behind me and I'm good to go. This might be shareable, but right lane. Very little traffic. Comes in spurts. Been picking up. I might as well move over here a little bit, no parking. I should mention that the California Vehicle Code, 21202, the far to the right, has all kinds of exceptions, including anywhere a right turn is authorized. So where you're approaching the driveway or intersection, you do not have to be far to the right. So you can see there are certainly intersections. Not too many driveways on this stretch. They seem to be they must have an alley behind. And so this essentially is a really wide lane. Typically use the right half. If there are lots of driveways, shopping center, or on-ramps and off-ramps, I probably control the left half. Still on Rodeo Road, I think. Yep. Take this to the end. Should leave us at Jefferson, or close to Jefferson. Now again, this is a 3 to 7 p.m. no stopping. No parking 12 to 2 p.m. Tuesday. So there's no parking here anyway. Nobody's parking, but they could. And then 3 to 7, that's the evening rush, leaving the city center of LA. This will be no parking to keep it clear for traffic. Here we have right turn only lane coming up. I'll let this guy come around. One more. I got plenty of time to get over there. All right, signal. And come over. This is La Cienega. Quarter mile, I turn left. Is that Jefferson? Why don't they tell you what street it is? And the warning. Would be nice. I should be drinking. Starting to get warmer here. That much traffic behind. Walk to end Alzheimer's. And I'd like to get over left here so I can see what's happening up ahead, particularly if there are oncoming traffic turning left so I can see them and they can see me, instead of being hidden, screened behind the vehicles. So now we have another lane coming in on the right, which is interesting. So I need to move over into that lane, which I can do easily. But now it's going to be a right turn lane again, so maybe not so smart. Yeah, I probably should have stayed where I was, but it's going to be a while. I gotta make a left turn someplace. It was a quarter mile. Let's see, Jefferson, that's where I wanna be. So I may not make it. Oh, if it turns down to a red, I can negotiate over. Yeah, I wanna get over. I got it. Here we go. That's the Baldwin Hills there. So we're coming back from downtown on the north side of the Baldwin Hills. We went downtown on the south side, around down by Madera Heights and Inglewood and South LA. It's maybe a slightly better neighborhood quality here on the south side. Now, what am I going to do here? This is really wide. I suspect there's going to be a bike lane, yep. So now I have the situation of the doors on bike lane on a multi-lane street. But there's not much traffic. So I'm going to control the lane and release as necessary. Yeah, I don't like this. This is really no fun. Okay, let me get on the left edge and see. Nope, that ain't working for me. Getting pretty good distance there. So this is the least fun part, dealing with doors on bike lanes on a multi-lane street. Instead of stuck between a rock and a hard place. Having the mirror is pretty useful. My helmet mirror or eyeglass mirror. Get a red light up here, so not slowing anybody down. This is detained. So I could take the bike lane the bike path back from here, if I so desire. Did we lose the bike lane? I hope. Yeah. Looks like we lose it. That might be least. He got plenty of room to get around. NPR is here. Culver City. NPR from Culver City. There you go. Let me get rid of the bike lane. At least for a little bit. Bike lane on the other side? No. It's still on Jefferson. It's a relief to get rid of the bike lane. Believe it or not. This feels like Culver now. Is this Jefferson? It is Jefferson. How does it feel like Culver to me? I don't think I've ridden down here before. I got the wind noise again. Because I'm usually on the bike path. As far as the bike path on the creek is concerned, probably you use it in daylight hours. Probably not in the dark. It was the door opening. I was attacked once on the bike path on the creek, but by a dog running free. Here I can let this guy by. Is the right turn lane? Yo. It's a parking lane. Go destination. Now this guy's gonna make a right turn? I don't think so. I'm not gonna be next to him to find out. Here we go. There he goes, right turn. Overland. Oh, that's nice. It's always nice to sneak in under the light. Larson Automotive. Ralph's. Probably 10:30. Mid morning. So I'm in Culver City now, that's pretty clear. This part of Jefferson is really nice. No bike lane, not too much traffic. Headline change. At least mid-morning. quarter mile turn left. Now, what's that going to bring me to? I just wanted to stay on Jefferson, but I think I got to wiggle off and on to Jefferson. Check behind for traffic accumulation. I will release here because it's wide and easy to do so. I can just keep rolling until it clears out. Dobson, Culver City. Now I'm gonna make a left on, I gotta check this here. I didn't recognize that name. Next something? A chato? Can't even see the damn phone. I don't know where I am. Let me look on Google Map. I'm Jefferson. My shadow. Jefferson? Can't see. Recenter that. Okay, so I'm gonna go on Jefferson. It turns into Sepulveda. Sepulveda. Arup. Okay, I'm gonna check the camera. Let me get in some shade here. Nice little side street. Yeah, this is cute. Keep it running. Grid battery, C8. According to this, wireless, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, okay. Bluetooth, I'm connected. Access to where the road is and see if we can get around on the sidewalk. It's a pain. From when to when? 9-7 to 10-15. Okay. Until mid-October. Let's see if I can get around. I mean, that's even nicer. Because obviously there's not going to be any traffic. Or very little. Only local traffic. Oh, they have a little detour. Well, let's see if we do that. If it's just a matter of going around a little bit, we'll get to see some neighborhood streets. And there may be some neighborhood streets that we could use instead of even Rodeo Road. So, check this out. Private GPS just gave me the audible signal that I'm off the route. I wonder if there's going to be another sign up here directing me around and back onto Rodeo Road. You never know what goes through. Don't see a sign, but I'm assuming that I can get through here on Coliseum Street. looks like it does go through. So here's a collector, two lane. Here's Crenshaw, where the work is being done. And now I'll decide if I want to get back up there or stay on this on Coliseum. Coliseum. Hey, want to come around? Want to come around? There you go. Happy way back. No way back. Not getting out. Have to check the video. I'm not seeing any waves. This is pretty good. There's no parking here. At least not now. Wonder why. So I'm on Coliseum. So this is it. I mean, once you wiggle around a little bit, you find a good route you like. I see no real disadvantage of using Coliseum. Where I am now, we still have a signal here on the busiest streets. Okay, here's the detour. Do I go back? Yeah, I'm gonna go back because this isn't gonna change much. I didn't have that sign up at the first right. So, not sure where I am now. Again, the ubiquitous residential street speed bumps, or speed humps, I guess. These are officially humps or bumps. Moving back up to Rodeo. Now, what is Rodeo? I'm going to get back on Jefferson, which is going to be a challenge, I think, but we'll see. In that, it's Doors Own Bike Lane. This is Rodeo. Now, it looks like traffic was deviated around the other side, too. I was on Buckingham here. Are we still blinking red? Yep. In the beautiful level. A lot of deviated traffic here. Making a left. We're gonna have to wait for the light to change. I get back on Rodeo. Could have got in front of the truck there, but okay, here I go. He comes through the yellow and now I got it. Okay, we're back on Rodeo Road after the detour around Crenshaw, which will last until October 15th. Good to know. Look at this. Is this not bicycling heaven? Look at this. Look at solar panels for the lights. That's interesting. You think they would just wire them up to the electrical grid, but must have been cheaper to do this for some reason. The advantage is getting the red light, but they can be useful to get across streets. The short one on Hillcrest. Thank you. heavy, huh? Don't know if that was friendly. Probably not. We call that the valley and territorial noise. When an animal, a mammal like a dog, sees you on his side or his sidewalk, it's all excited, barks. You think you shouldn't be there. So here I'll move over. No reason to really, so I'm gonna go back. Little traffic, and better to be out here and relevant. So we're still on Rodeo, that's Rodeo Lane, and Rodeo Road, double Rodeo. I slowed down a little bit here, 15 miles an hour. What do we have here on the right? Electrical vehicle charging station. What is that? This is Rancho Cienega Sports Center. Tennis, swimming pool, skate. I'm sure it's roller skate, I would guess. King Boulevard. The traffic merge left, so we get a right turn lane up here. Baldwin Village. Okay, so there's our neighborhood sign. I wish I saw Marlo so I know where I was. Baldwin Village. King Boulevard and Rodeo Road. Traffic goes to my right. This is going to be turning right, I imagine. So I'm out of his way. Traffic going through gets on my left. U-Haul, that's a fancy U-Haul. Here I am at McDonald's at La Brea. La Brea and Rodeo Road. A little bit more traffic now. Come on, come on, come on. Thank you. It's leaving. I'm going to release here because I have this whole right lane. So there's a release on green. Get a long distance here to let the traffic by, bus stop, let it clear out, light turns red behind me and I'm good to go. This might be shareable, but wide lane. Very little traffic, comes in spurts. Been picking up. I might as well move over here a little bit, no parking. I should mention that the California Vehicle Code, 21202, the far to the right, has all kinds of exceptions, including anywhere a right turn is authorized. So where you're approaching the driveway or intersection, you do not have to be far to the right. So as you can see, there are certainly intersections. Not too many driveways on this stretch. They seem to be they must have an alley behind. And so this essentially is a really wide lane. Typically use the right half. If there are lots of driveways, shopping center, or on-ramps and off-ramps, I'd probably control the left half. Still on Rodeo Road, I think. Yep. Take this to the end. Should leave us at Jefferson, or close to Jefferson. Now again, this is a 3 to 7 p.m. no stopping. No parking 12 to 2 p.m. Tuesday. So there's no parking here anyway. Somebody's parking. But they could. And then 3 to 7, that's the evening rush. Leaving the city center of L.A., this will be no parking to keep it clear for traffic. Here we have right turn only lane coming up. I'll let this guy come around. One more. I got plenty of time to get over there. All right, signal. And come over. This is La Cienega. Quarter mile, I turn left. Is that Jefferson? Why don't they tell you what street it is? And the warning. That'd be nice. I should be drinking. Starting to get warmer here. That much traffic behind. Walk to end Alzheimer's. And I like to get over left here so I can see what's happening up ahead, particularly if there are oncoming traffic turning left, so I can see them and they can see me, instead of being hidden, screened behind the vehicles. So now we have another lane coming in on the right, which is interesting. So I need to move over into that lane, which I can do easily. But now it's going to be a right turn lane again, so maybe not so smart. Yeah, I probably should have stayed where I was, but it's going to be a while. I gotta make a left turn someplace. It was a quarter mile. Let's see, Jefferson, that's where I want to be. So I may not make it. Oh, if it turns down to a red, I can negotiate over. Yeah, I want to get over. I got it. Here we go. That's the Baldwin Hills there. So we're coming back from downtown on the north side of the Baldwin Hills. we went downtown on the south side, around down by Padera Heights and Inglewood and South LA. It's maybe a slightly better neighborhood quality here on the south side. What am I going to do here? Am I going to... This is really wide. I suspect there's going to be a bike lane, yep. So now I have the situation of the doors on bike lane on a multi-lane street. But there's not much traffic. So I'm going to control the lane and release as necessary. Yeah, I don't like this. This is really no fun. Okay, let me get on the left edge and see. Nope, that ain't working for me. Getting pretty good distance there. So this is the least fun part, dealing with doors on bike lanes on a multi-lane street. Sort of stuck between a rock and a hard place. And having the mirror is pretty useful. My helmet mirror or eyeglass mirror. Got a red light up here, so not slowing anybody down. This is the cane. So I could take the bike lane. The bike path back from here, if I so desire. Did we lose the bike lane? I hope. Yeah. Looks like we lose it. He got plenty of room to get around. NPR is here. Culver City. NPR from Culver City. There you go. Let me get rid of the bike lane. At least for a little bit. Bike lane on the other side? No. I'm still in Jefferson. Ah. The it's a release to get rid of the bike lane. Believe it or not. This feels like Culver now. Is this Jefferson? It is Jefferson. How does it feel like Culver to me? I don't think I've ridden down here before. I got the wind noise again. Because I'm usually on the bike path. As far as the bike path on the creek is concerned, probably you use it in daylight hours. Probably not in the dark. It was the door opening. I was attacked once on the bike path on the creek, but by a dog running free. Here I can let this guy by. Is the right turn lane? Yo. It's a parking lane. No destination. Now this guy's gonna make a right turn? I don't think so. I'm not gonna be next to him to find out. There we go. There we go, it's right turn. Overland. Oh, that's nice. It's always nice to sneak in under the light. Larson Automotive. Ralph's. Probably 10:30. Good morning. So I'm in Culver City now, that's pretty clear. This part of Jefferson is really nice. No bike lane, not too much traffic. Headline change. At least mid-morning. Quarter mile turn left. Now, what's that going to bring me to? I just wanted to stay on Jefferson, but I think I got to wiggle off and on to Jefferson. Check behind for traffic accumulation. I will release here because it's wide and easy to do so. I can just keep rolling until it clears out. Dobson, Culver City. Now I'm going to make a left on, I'm going to check this here. I didn't recognize that name. Next something? A chato? Can't even see the damn phone. I don't know where I am. Let me look on Google Map. And Jefferson. My shadow. Jefferson. Jefferson. Can't see. Recenter that. Okay, so I'm going to go on Jefferson. It turns into Sepulveda. Sepulveda. Arab. Okay, I'm gonna check the camera. Let me get in some shade here. Nice little side street. Ah, this is cute. Keep it running. Good battery, 58. According to this, wireless, Wi-Fi, Bluetooth, okay. Bluetooth, I'm connected. Gone. Battery still cooking. 3 hours left of memory. Put that back in there, straighten it out a little bit. Looks pretty good. Okay, we're rolling again. So we're gonna go down here. Exit. Go by car. Yeah. So I just head down. I'm going to move into Sepulveda. I see. Forks, and then I make a right back on Jefferson. Easy enough. So I'm going down here. I'm going to make a little right and then a left on Sepulveda as it ends. Okay, let's check it out. Shouldn't have to get in the left lane, I don't think. Are we blinking? Yep. Hopefully the mic is working, so I don't have to do a voiceover. The cute little street here. Bayona. Bayona Lane. There we go. Oh, I can actually do it from the right lane. Okay. You remember that for next time. And I think it's a right back onto Jefferson. It doesn't go through here for some reason. Phone case factory. So I like this route better. Of course, it's a different time of day compared to the one, the south route, south of Baldwin Hills. The neighborhood streets I didn't like so much. The neighborhoods maybe not quite as comfortable. Coming down Flower was fun. That's one way south, so you need to find another one. But it's, you can use Figueroa. I mean, that's irrelevant because you're going to go. It's what you do at Exposition Park. It makes a difference. And here I got an Exposition Boulevard, and then Rodeo Road, and then Rodeo Road to Jefferson, Sepulveda, back to Jefferson. That's not bad. And again, once I was back there in Culver City, I could have got on the bike path as well, which is a good daylight option. A dual destination lane works out well. I think I'm gonna lose it though up here. Yep. So I'll hang on a little bit. You're gonna make a right on Jefferson in a quarter mile. This guy behind me wants to make a right turn. I'll let him do that. Here's my red light. Get the road to myself. Only have a quarter mile to go. So easy. Okay. Quarter mile and I'll be back on Jefferson. Jefferson says left. How do I do that? Oh, Jefferson is to the right. There we go, that's right. Easy way to come back. That was a straight shot down Jefferson. Again, you could do a little side streets to Playa Vista, the commercial area on the runway and whatever, but let's stay on Jefferson. Now here we have an interchange with the 405, so I gotta watch this right lane. Yeah, right lane, turn right ahead, so I need to get out of this right lane. I'd let this guy go by me, but it's really hard to move this bike across, and the mid lane is kind of narrow, so he's going to have to wait. Okay, so now I need to get out of this lane. I'll roll easy and look for a chance. I'm looking at my mirror. I got a signal. Thank you. He comes over just as I want to get over. I don't know what he's doing. Why is he in the right lane to begin with? Is he trying to come around me? I don't know what he's doing. Don't know what he's doing. Still behind me. Get out of his way. Can't even see with the darkened windows what he's about. Ah, Okay. Interchanges. You just drive them. I would have gotten in that left lane earlier, or out of the right lane earlier if I had known what was coming up. Sometimes you don't have to. Sometimes the on-ramp is a dual destination lane. So you don't need to get out, but I think more often you do. If it's an interchange. And of course you know it's an interchange because you'll see signs indicating the presence of the freeway. If it's not interchange, then right lane will probably just go right through with no problem. Under or over. Here's LA's finest. As I move into Playa Vista, a planned community. Ah, here we got a stand-up board, looks like. Wonder what construction is happening here. A7, I don't think I've ever seen an A7 before, Audi. Wow. 3 liter. Quattro. Pretty fancy car. Got some traffic behind. But it's going slow in front, so let's see if we need to release here. And I think this will be a temporary lane reduction as I move over here. I think we'll get the lane back again. There we do. LMU, they have some buildings here. We have Marymount University. They're mostly up on the bluff in Westchester. I never realized they had such a presence here down below the bluff in Playa Vista. So here's some thinking about why I feel so safe doing this. Basically, a motorist is going to have to clearly violate the law to hit you when you're operating, controlling the lane. And even a motorist who is somewhat not paying attention, you're making it easy because you are so relevant and obvious. So you're really, by using cycling savvy techniques and lane control, you have two things to worry about. You have the psychopaths who may hate bicycles and bicyclists and want to do you harm, which of course is a tiny, tiny, tiny percentage of the population of drivers, motorists. Or you have people who are grossly negligent, seriously distracted. But Darwin takes care of them anyway. They will most likely be eliminated before they meet you. I mean, if they are on their cell phone so much that they're texting, and not even looking up or glancing up once every 10 seconds or something like that, they're going to run into somebody, anybody in front of them, or go through a red light and get smacked or whatever. So they have to be really, really negligent. And so, and again, they are self-correcting or self-filtering or whatever. There you go, come on. There you go. No waves today. I can't get any waves. I want friendly waves. So this is Jefferson, the main drag of Playa Vista. And up here is a group. So I'm gonna pull in there. So I just went from their future headquarters in Wilshire Grand Center to their current headquarters, Westside LA in Playa Vista. Hi there. Can I get through there? Oh, they have a electric recharging, not being used. So, here we are in Arup. Which one is Arup? Which building is Arup?
What?
Arup.
Arup?
Yeah.
There? I said building D.
Oh, that one, D?
What is it, Dave?
You call it Arup?
Arup.
Arup.
Uh-huh.
Arup.
That's exactly.
And all these bikes here, they belong to who, these guys? Is that...
A company that has a mouth.
Is it a private company then?
Yeah.
Need to look at that. Interesting. Huh. Let's take a look. As we hear in Arup. Come on. Come on, camera, come off. There we go. So what do we have here at Arup? Oh, these are the Zagsters, yeah. So that's a dock system. This is an interesting bike. So these probably belong to some company here. An interesting bike rack. And they all have their own locks on them. Huh. So here we are at Arup in D. I'm going to sit down over there in the shade a little bit. Put this back in. No easy way to get up there. To jump the curb. Digital. Okay, put that off.